Hello viewers, welcome to JSM. In this lecture, we are going to start a new topic, that is states of matter. Okay, so in the states of matter, in the class 11, we discuss the gaseous state and the liquid state, and in the class 12, we discuss the solid state. Okay, so here we start with the gaseous state in this lecture. In that one, the first thing is that the parameters of a gas are the measurable properties of gases. Okay, those we discuss here. To describe the state of a gas, we need four parameters, or to define a gas completely, we need four parameters. What are they? So those are, first one is mass. Okay, mass of the gas, or number of moles. Okay, number of moles of the gas means we should know how much quantity of gas is present, what is the mass or how many moles. Next, second one is that volume of the gas, that is denoted by V. And next one is that pressure of the gas denoted by P. And fourth one is temperature at which the gas is present. Okay, so that is denoted by T. So we need total four parameters to describe the state of a gas, means how many moles of gas is present, or how many grams of gas is present, what is the volume occupied by the gas, what is the pressure exerted by the gas, and what is the temperature of that gas. Okay, so these four parameters are essential to describe state of a gas. Okay, so now here these four are the measurable properties, means which can be calculated experimentally. We can measure what is the weight of the gas, or how many moles of gas is present, or what is the volume, what is the pressure, at which temperature that gas is present. So these are experimentally they can be determined. Okay, let us see one by one. First we start with the mass or number of moles of the gas. Now let us see the first one, that is mass of the gas or number of moles of the gas. Generally we think that gas is very light, but even though it is very light, it has some mass. The mass of a gas can be experimentally determined. Let us see, suppose we have a container. Okay, so first we will take a container which has the gas. Okay, we consider a container in which gas is present. Now, so its weight W1 for example, and later by removing all these gas, we will calculate the weight of empty container. Okay, first we have measured the weight of the container which has the gas, and after removing the gas as much as we can, and we will calculate the weight of the container. So therefore, if we mass of gas is nothing but W1 minus W2. Sir, no, very simple experiment this one. So this is the weight of container plus gas, yes sir, because gas is also present. So that's why here only container weight is W2. So if you want to get the mass of the gas, weight of the container minus weight of the empty container. Okay, so in this way we can easily calculate the mass of the gas. And here the units for mass, units are important. Units for mass are generally we express in grams or in kilogram. Okay, gram or kilogram. And the interconversion between these two also very important. 1 kg equal to 1000 grams, that we can write as 10 power 3 gram. So now 1 kg, 1 kilogram equal to 10 power 3 gram. Or if you want in grams, 1 gram is equal to 10 power minus 3 kilogram. Yes or no? 1 kg equal to 10 power 3 gram. If you bring this 10 power 3 this side, that becomes 1 kg by 10 power 3 that goes into the numerator that becomes 10 power minus 3. Okay, so 1 gram equal to 10 power minus 3 kilogram. Okay, and then after getting the mass, it is necessary to calculate the number of moles of the gas sometime. So that's why number of moles formula we know very well. So number of moles n is equal to mass of the gas, not only gas, any substance, but here we are discussing about the gases. So that's why I am taking here as mass of the gas in grams by molar mass of that gas. Okay, molar mass of that gas in grams mole inverse or grams per mole. Okay, clear? So this is for the calculation of number of moles. We can get by using this relation, number of moles of gas equal to mass of the gas by molar mass of the gas. Okay, so this is about the mass of the gas and number of moles of the gas. This interconversion is very very important. Sometimes in the question they will give in grams, but in the option they will give in kilograms, or in question they will give in kilograms and in the option they will give in grams. Okay, so that's why this interconversion is very important. Now let us see the second one, that is the volume. Okay, so here we know that the gases do not have any fixed volume. Okay, the volume of the gas is nothing but the volume of the vessel or volume of the container in which gas is taken. Best example, suppose we have a container, this one. In this one we have some gas. Okay, now the volume of the gas is nothing but the volume of this container. Suppose same gas is taken in another big container. Now this gas occupies the total volume of this container or this vessel. Means now the volume of the gas is equal to the volume of the container. Okay, so in this way the volume of gas is not fixed. The vessel or the container in which we take the gas, that volume of that container is nothing but the volume of the gas. Okay, so that can be calculated by the using dimensions of the container or vessel in which gas is present. Okay, how can we calculate the volume? By utilizing the dimensions of the container or vessel in which gas is present. Now here, see here, if we look at the units, very very important here, generally we use liter. Okay, mostly we use liter as the unit for the volume, but actually the SI unit is cubic meter. Okay, cubic meter, that is meter cube, we'll write like this. Okay, cubic meter is the SI unit, but actually it is a very big unit. So that's why generally the volume of the gas is expressed in the liters, centimeter cube or decimeter cube. Clear? The SI unit of volume is cubic meter, but this is a very big unit, so that's why we do not use this one most frequently, we use liter. Okay, now let us see the interconversions, which are very very important. 1 liter is equal to 10 power minus 3 cubic meters. Okay, 1 liter equal to 10 power minus 3 cubic meters. So from this one, if we want 1 meter cube or 1 cubic meter is equal to 10 power 3 liter. So no, 1 cubic meter equal to 10 power 3 liter. Okay, so here for 1 liter we are discussing other units, how to convert them. And 1 liter equal to, we know that 10 power 3 ml, milliliter. Okay, 10 power 3 milliliter. And one more thing, while writing these units also, see here we should write, this is a small m and this is the capital L we should write. Both are small or both are capital, that is actually wrong. Next, 1 liter is also equal to 10 power 3 cubic centimeters, because here 1 milliliter is equal to 1 cubic centimeter. Okay, 1 milliliter is equal to 1 cubic centimeter. So that's why here in the place of milliliter we are getting cubic centimeter. Clear? Next, 1 liter is also equal to 1 decimeter cube. 1 liter is also equal to 1 decimeter cube. So here 1 decimeter is equal to 10 centimeter. 1 decimeter is equal to 10 centimeter. Or 1 decimeter is also equal to 0.1 meter. 0.1 meter, because we know that 1 meter is equal to 10 power 2 centimeter. 1 meter equal to 10 power 2 centimeter. Clear? So here that's why 1 liter we are converting it into cubic meters, milliliters, cubic centimeters and cubic decimeters or decimeter cube generally we use here. Clear? So and these are the different types of units and how they are interrelate to each other. Very very important. Remember this SI unit of volume is cubic meter. Now let us see the third parameter, that is pressure. So generally we have a definition that force per unit area is called pressure, P equal to F by A. But what is that force per unit area? What is that? That we are going to discuss a very interesting and important this one. Suppose in a particular container we have some gas. Now let us see. Suppose three gas molecules, for understanding purpose easily we are considering like that. So we have three gas molecules. Now the gas molecules are always in motion. Okay, gas molecules are always moving. While they are moving, they collide with the walls of the container like this. Okay, the gas molecules, when they are moving, what is happening? They are colliding with the walls of the container. Now this gas molecules exert some outward force. Okay, this gas molecules exert some outward force on the walls of the container. That force is generating due to the collision of gas molecules with the walls of the container. Okay, what is happening here? The gas molecules are moving, they are colliding with the walls of the container and they are showing some outward force. Okay, now the force, this force is nothing but the force which is generated due to the collisions of gas molecules on the walls of the container. Clear? So the force of the gas molecules due to the collisions per unit area is nothing but pressure of the gas. Clear? Very simple. Force per unit area. What is that force? The force which is generated due to the collision of gas molecules with the walls of the container in which that gas is present. That is the force. Okay. That force per unit area is nothing but pressure of the gas. Clear? Very simple and extensively this once again we discuss in the kinetic molecular theory of gases. Now, units for the pressure. So, units. The SI unit of pressure is Pascal. Okay, SI unit of pressure is Pascal. With respect to the scientist name, this is given Pascal. Symbol is PA. But this Pascal is a very small unit. Okay, its value is very small. So that's why generally we express the pressure in the bar or in the atmosphere. In the bar or in the atmosphere. So let us see here the interconversions by taking one atmosphere equal to, in the different types of units, the interrelation let us see now. One atmosphere is equal to 76 centimeter of Hg. One atmosphere equal to 76 centimeter of Hg. Or one atmosphere is equal to 760 mm of Hg, millimeter of Hg. 76 centimeter of Hg or 760 mm of Hg. And also one atmosphere is equal to 760 torr, because here One tar is equal to 1 mm of Hg. 1 mm of Hg. Okay, so this is for tar. Next, 1 atmosphere is equal to 1.01325 into 10^6 dyn per square centimeter. Okay, 1.01325 into 10^6 dyn per square centimeter. Or this is also equal to 1.01325 into 10^5 newton per square meter. Okay, newton per square meter. This is dyn per square centimeter 10^6, because here 1 newton per square meter equal to 10 dyn per square centimeter. So that's why we are getting here 10^6 dyn square centimeter power minus 2, here 10^5 newton square meter. Clear? And also this is equal to 1.01325 into 10^5 pascal, because 1 newton meter power minus 2 equal to 1 pascal. Next, this is also is equal to 101.325 kilopascal. Okay, 101.325 kilopascal. From this one, if it is multiplied with 10^2, we get 101.325. kilo equal to 10^3, we know that. So that's why here we get like this. And this is also equal to 1.01325 bar. 1.01325 bar. So here, 1 bar is equal to 10^5 pascal. 1 bar is equal to 10^5 pascal. And also 1 bar is equal to 0.987 atmosphere. 1 bar equal to 0.987 atmosphere. So these are the different units for the pressure which we use extensively and their interrelation. Clear? So generally we express the pressure in the bar or in the atmosphere, but actually SI unit of pressure is pascal, but it is a very small value. See here, 1 bar equal to 10^5 pascal. 1 pascal means 10^-5 bar. Okay, very small value. So that's why we are taking this bar or atmosphere generally to express the pressure. Now the last parameter is temperature T. And temperature of a gas means the temperature of a gas gives the information about the energy of the gas particles, means how energetic are the gas particles. More temperature means the gas particles are highly energetic. Low temperature means gas particles have less energy. Or temperature is also the degree of hotness. More temperature means more hot body. Less temperature, or a body that low temperature, means it has low hotness. Okay, so the temperature of a gas is the measure of energy of the gas particle. More temperature, the energy of gas particles is more. Low temperature means energy of the gas particles is less. So generally here temperature is measured in thermodynamic scale, that is in Kelvin scale, or in the degree centigrade, or in the degree Fahrenheit. So let us see the interconversion. So temperature in Kelvin is equal to temperature in degrees centigrade plus 273.15. Okay, temperature in Kelvin is equal to temperature in degrees centigrade plus 273.15. Also, temperature in degrees centigrade is equal to 5/9 into degree Fahrenheit minus 32. Okay, degree Fahrenheit minus 32, or temperature in degree Fahrenheit is equal to 9/5 into degree centigrade plus 32. Okay, so these are the scales which we use to measure the temperature. This is the SI unit, temperature in Kelvin. Okay, so and this is the relationship between Kelvin and degree centigrade, and this is the relationships between degree centigrade and degree Fahrenheit. Okay. Thank you for watching. Please subscribe to our channel to support us.